Happy New Year. I am downtown Chicago. I came downtown because I needed a bit of a staycation. I had been, you know, on Christmas break like everyone else, and just seemed like with everything so close to downtown Chicago, a lot of people don't live in the city when they get of a particular age. They, you know, come downtown. For me, it's 28 miles away, and so I stayed at the Virgin Hotel for New Year's Eve and stayed a couple extra days over so I could repeat the hotel. So I wanted to bring you the goods. Basically, I wrote down everything. I didn't have paper. So I wrote down my quad, the one eat to go bag from the restaurant here in the hotel. So anyway, bottom line, what I can say is I overall, this was a pleasant experience. The people who work here are so nice. Just, you know, from the basic questions and, you know, like, hey, can I get your bag? Who are you? And, you know, the one guy gave me his card and was like, can you please leave the hotel a review? And I was like, I'll do that. I didn't get specific that, you know, I was doing a review of the hotel or whatever, but he did share that they get a little bone if you go on, I think it's TripAdvisor, and mention them by name. They get a $25 recognition award every time their name is mentioned. So, overall, staff has been phenomenal. So, the room was clean. It's basically, I had a two... I don't know if those are full size or queen size beds, but anyway, two beds in the room. So for New Year's Eve night, it was one of my girlfriends and myself when we went to the New Year's Eve party here at the hotel. And so she spent the night that night, and then, you know, we did brunch the next day, and the brunch spot is Miss Ricky, so I'll review the restaurants in a minute. But basically the party was upstairs at Cerise on the rooftop. And it was fun. It was really fun. We bought, I bought a ticket in advance online. And then when she got here, they had a setup here on the second floor where I'm at now. And that's the other thing. They have a bunch of different chill out spots. And I like that. So it's a boutique hotel, but it's got, you know, these loungy, several different areas where you can kind of relax and kick back and drink a cup of coffee. Or it's evening time here, so it's like 6 p.m. Mm. So it's my happy hour. But basically she bought her ticket for half off day of event, and so we celebrated on the rooftop, took some nice Instagram moments. And basically, I would just say that the room is separated into two. Like one whole side is a dressing room. And so that's the bathroom, the separate sort of two sinks, the ironing board, there's a really nice vanity. And so plenty of room, actually. And I think what I liked about it most is that this hotel, maybe it's the rooms, you know, they're hardwood floor. They had two windows in it. I don't know if it was because we were in a corner unit or what, but basically lots of light. It felt like an apartment. And I noticed that on their website, they do have accommodations for seven nights or more. So this is a perfect place, I think, in downtown Chicago if a person wants to have a place that, you know, for the weekend or more, that feels a bit like a staycation like mine has been. And it's been perfect. It was like a little apartment. So it has a refrigerator, basically, you know, Wi-Fi, TV, coffee in the room. Now, they do also have room service, but only until I think like 3 o'clock, because Miss Ricky's is the brunch place and they close at 3, and that's the only thing that does room service. So I called late in the evening one evening, and I learned by experience. If you want something to eat, then the rooftop bar Cerise is open until 10, and I think they serve food till maybe the kitchen closes at 9. But you know, that's, you know, I don't know if those are pandemic hours or what, but I think if they're having an event up there, it's a lot later. I just feel like, you know, the way I can sort of describe this experience is that the second thing is it's super pet friendly, which I love, because staying not too far from home, you know, I have my dog with me. And so she is right now lounging. She's probably wishing that we would go for a little walk. But anyway, the hotel is pet friendly, and it's all over their website that, you know, they ask what kind of biscuits do they like, what kind of treats do they like. They also ask, you know, that you fill out this like online form before you check in, because they give you and your little refrigerator, that was smeg little refrigerator, and they'll stock it with, you know, like if you want sparkling water or still water. You know, what kind of snacks do you like? I didn't see anything in there that would be out of the ordinary, but I did put on there that I like sparkling white wine. That was in my fridge. I don't know if that was a coincidence or what, but it was Moët, so I didn't open it. Because I think there's places here in the hotel you can just sort of get something. I didn't need the whole bottle. Let me see. They also, I was like, no, I won't put that. But I was like, why not? In the morning, sometimes when I'm running, you know, sort of physically on E, I like a Red Bull. I like the small can. I think it's maybe 8 ounces or something like that. There was a Red Bull in my refrigerator. So again, as I think through this, what are the odds? Because usually hotels will stock Red Bull in your mini fridge? Or do they? I don't know. Somebody drop down in the comments and let me know. But I know I've traveled and I've never seen Red Bull. So for me, it's always like, where can I, you know, sometimes in the morning, like, where can I get a Red Bull? Where can I get a, you know, I have a structure in the morning. I like my coffee. Then I do my 8 ounce can of Red Bull, and then I'll drink like an unsweetened tea. It's just a thing. So it was in the fridge. So I don't know if that was a coinky date. I don't think so, because I did fill out the form. But on the other hand, I filled out the form for dog treats, and I haven't seen any, but they've been very friendly to my dog. I've taken her, you know, when we bought the ticket for my friend to go to the New Year's Eve party, I took her here and stood in line. So the hotel has been so sweet to Coco, and I've never not once felt like, oh my God, I have a dog. So I would definitely come back here again and stay, for sure. What else did I write down on my notes? Let's see. All right, so I'm going to show some clips as part of this video while I'm talking. But, you know, I did feel like, you know, everything was really superb. If I had to do anything in terms of feedback, I would say, because this does have like sort of an apartment vibe, it does. I know it's a hotel, but they've got places downstairs for breakfast, brunch, and then upstairs for, you know, they have an abbreviated menu, but it's still good stuff. But if I take it back to my room, it's like, it gets cold. There's no microwave. So I would just say, if you have a fridge, and this hotel is kind of I want to say edgy. I want to say Virgin Hotels, probably. You know, I don't know enough to call it a throwback, but I do remember when they had the Virgin record stores. Remember that? Like, you would go to cities like New York, and they would have the biggest record store, or one of the biggest. Like, here in Chicago on Michigan Avenue, like, the Virgin record store. And they'd have a bunch of artists, like, do record signings and stuff. You know, I think this may not be a throwback. It was built in 2015. But at the same time, one of the people that work here told me that they had went from, like, you know, a lower number in terms of TripAdvisor to now they're number seven. So they're working really hard. When I told them I was going to do, I mentioned to the guy at the desk, like, I'm going to do a review. And I think he thought just on TripAdvisor. But I was like, no, I'm going to do a review on YouTube. And he was like, oh, good. That would help us because we're trying to get back up there, you know. So, again, I don't think this is an old hotel. Everything looks new. But it is quirky. It's edgy. But it's playful. You know, I noticed, like, even in the elevator, they have a, for the floors to go up and down, it's sort of like a chocolate bar, but the edge of the wrapper is ripped off, and it'll tell you, like, you want to go to 26 for the rooftop, you want to go to 2 for the, this area is called the social area. So there's lots of games, there's books. As I came to this area, there were two girls in the lounge area over there that kind of laid down. And then I noticed they were both reading a book. And then there were people, it seemed like maybe they were just stopping through the hotel. But they came to sit and talk. And so I just love it. And I would definitely come back. I would say overall for me, because it's pet friendly and they don't charge for you to bring your pet, that just made me, I mean, I don't like to be without my dog, and I never thought I'd be one of those kind of people, but she's a security blanket for me. So the fact that she can come and then nobody treats us bad because he like a dog, you know. I know that some places are really open to dogs, like maybe California or other places, Chicago. I don't see people taking their dog in everywhere, but but there are hotels that will allow you to bring your pet, of course, but they charge. And so I've stayed here a couple of nights, and they don't charge for the pen. And they're, again, for me, that's a 5-star. Because, you know, most of the time, hotels, they charge for them. I did notice that it's a green hotel. There's, like, no paper in the room, which is why I had to write notes or a paper bag. But I'm not mad at it because I feel like, you know, totally wasteful. And I noticed that there's no paper towels in the bathroom. Oh. The only paper in my room was toilet paper. Anyway, you know, it's a non-smoking room. There's red accents all around. So if you know Virgin, you know, like, it's that red writing, Virgin. Remember first? Like, am I the only one that remembers, like, the record stores? But, you know, Richard Branson, who is the owner of this, he also has a cruise line. So I would like to check that out. I think it's an adult cruise line. So, but it's those red cursive Virgin. And so all over this hotel, which I think is also very, maybe, I think he's from London or England. It's very red accents all over the place. So a couple other things that I want to tell you about is for the room, there's an app for your phone, and that is called Lucy. And Lucy is available in the App Store, and then maybe Samsung phones, it's Marketplace, but it's called Lucy. So Virgin Hotels. And with the app, you can control the heat and air conditioning, as well as the lights. And then it gives you access to information. You can also use it as your room key. So my experience was that it didn't really work, but maybe I should have done it before I came here, because it said right on the app it takes 24 hours to recognize the reservation. So, you know, alternatively, it is on the TV. So there's a flat panel TV in the room, and the whole screen is a smart TV. So basically, use your remote and you can control all that stuff, you know, like just like at home. So the lights and the basically the air conditioning and the heat. And then there's access to like events that are going on in the hotel, or area restaurants and things to do, and also the menus for the restaurants. And so let's talk about the restaurants. So they were fine with me. Again, so the thing I should mention is this is a boutique hotel. And so it's, you know, I think boutique is basically, you know, it's not like the Marriott. It's not like something with a like a big old lobby and you know, it's not huge. And so they have a rooftop restaurant, and the name of that is Cerise. It does have a short menu, but it's good food. And so I'm good with, you know, the staple items. So for me, you know, what I got was, they have tacos, and I'm a taco fan. So shrimp taco fan. So they have pork tacos, they have shrimp tacos, and they had mushroom tacos, which is different. But I got the shrimp and mushroom tacos. And so the shrimp tacos are, they have a little bit of a kick to it. It's like the sauce they put in it, but it has pickled red onion and a, like a corn shell. So good. It was so good. The mushroom taco, it's almost just like mushroom. They're like marinate, like sauteed mushrooms in a shell. So if you like mushrooms, like I love mushrooms, you know, it's good, but it's a, so for me, what I ended up doing was I got the Caesar salad, and it came with some added protein. You could add shrimp, chicken, or steak. So like, let's say one time I added steak, right? And so I just left the taco open and ate the mushrooms, like with my steak and my salad. So even though they have a short menu, I should say, the food is like that Caesar salad. I think that's my new thing that I'm enjoying. I know that dressing is kind of heavy, probably not the healthiest. But anyway, maybe I'll start my diet January 3rd. So anyway, but the food's good, Cerise. And so, you know, I will have a menu here. But then also, so Miss Ricky's then is downstairs. So Cerise is upstairs. Like they, it's a restaurant, event space, rooftop bar. Downstairs is Miss Ricky's. And so when I got there was the cream cheese stuffed French toast, and it was good. It was really good. I thought it was really pretty presentation, and it's not necessarily stuffed. It's the French bread put together, crisp on both sides, but then it's got like kind of like a schmear of French cream cheese, in the middle of the French toast. So that's got all those candy pecans, and whipped cream. It was really good, and some fruit. And then I also got the farmer's breakfast one day. So that was like the bacon, and I think it was turkey, bacon, egg, two eggs your way, and the herb roasted potatoes. The potatoes are meh. I mean, but, you know, it just is an acquired taste. But definitely it was good. And then one day I ordered room service, and that's Miss Ricky's until 3, and I got the breakfast sandwich, which is like ham, a fried egg, some sort of cheese. It looked melty and good. came with a little bit of fruit, and I got coffee with it. So it came with a cute little coffee decanter, and they start you off with a little coffee in your cup. But, and it had the smallest little thing of Tabasco sauce I've ever seen in my life. It was so cute. But the breakfast sandwich was good. It had, like, some, to me, it tasted like Black Hills. I think that's what it called, Black Hills ham. Black Hills ham? I don't know. But anyway, it's sort of one whole situation. It also has avocados on it. It's on a croissant. So it was, again, it was good. So this hotel does also have a meeting space. And the meeting space is on a separate floor. But for meeting planners out there, I do know, so, you know, that they work with meeting planners and event planners. And there's some sort of percentage that you can seek here. So I did see a work group. So when I went up to Cerise to get something this evening, I noticed a group of people coming in. It looked like they were coming. Actually, it was a whole group. It looked like they were coming from work or something like that. So I think these spaces are nice. And I will tell you this. This whole floor that I'm on right now, maybe it's because it's a weeknight, but I'm the only one up here. Yeah. So I'm not complaining, but it is so fun. It's a so fun place. Like, so they did tell me for New Year's that there are people that just kind of live in the neighborhood and they come over here and get dinner and get drinks and kind of hang out and then go boom boom it. You know, so it does give me that impression too as a nice neighborhood place, because I sat here and kind of, you know, again, wrote my notes. Yeah, nobody's bothered me. Everything's been copacetic. So as I mentioned, there was a New Year's Eve party here. And so I bought my ticket online, and it was thrown by company, I would say the DJ. It didn't say specifically, you know, anything about what type of music it was. I was curious. I was like, I don't know what I'm buying a ticket for. But, you know, it's at a hotel downtown, and it's probably mainstream, just a mix of different people. And because I've been to New Year's Eve parties before in downtown Chicago. So here's the bottom line. I had so much fun at that party. It was a new experience for me, because it started to become apparent to my friend. She was like, what kind of party is this? Did you read the print? I think you missed them. And I was like, no, I didn't say anything. I mean, it was like, just said ticket prices. It said it's thrown by, you know, Dom. And the name listed some DJs. And I couldn't put a finger on, you know, is this the party that I want to go to? But the point was, for us, was just like, we're just trying to have an evening out. And this is where I was going to be. And we're just trying to get up to, you know, where the excitement is. It was like not even a big deal. We weren't looking for the party of the year or anything like that. It was not specific to that. But yeah. So I asked when she was buying her ticket, and I was like, hey, what kind of crowd are you guys gonna have? Coco see somebody. Somebody came up here. Down killer. So, you know, I was sort of wondering, like, what kind of party is this anyway? Because I see the line forming. And, in fact, when I was valet parking my car, I got out and there was, you know, a group of people standing. So, it was a diverse crowd. It was very much so a diverse crowd. It was Black, white, Puerto Rican, and Haitian. And it was sponsored by LGBTQ. And we had no idea until, you know, again, it started to become apparent to us. So we talked to the guy who was throwing the party. He was like, oh, no, you can come. Because that was our thing. Like, can we come? I mean, I'm sure that it was fine. So he said they have this party here every year. Like, for the past 4 or 5 years, they have this party here. And so just know if you're going to come to this hotel on New Year's Eve, that party is a, you know, I don't want to call it like a pride party, but it is sponsored by a group. How do you say it? Like the party promoters? LGBTQ. So, but did I have the time of my life? Yes, I did. It was super fun. You know, so anyway, just take note. And there were other people who were surprised as well. We were running into people in the elevator, and we were like, "Are you going to the party?" And they were like, "We bought tickets." So, I think another recommendation I would have would be, you know, I know that it was explained to me they're a third party who comes and throw a party every year, but at the same time, if you are in conjunction with a hotel, like, put more details about just like what kind of music they play or who's the sponsor, you know. It was a bit of a trick bag, but it was fun though. So for the third night, I decided to upgrade and get a different room. I wanted to try the room that's got 501 square feet and it is three separate rooms. And so when you walk in, the front room is basically, you know, a couch, like a whole area, like a couch, refrigerator, coffee pots, the snacks, a desk area. And it's, you know, a nice size to, let's say, you know, if you're having people over to your room downtown and you want to entertain a bit, it's a nice sitting area. It really is, because it separates your room completely from the front area. The one thing I would say is that I wish that the couch pulled out to a bed, because I have friends, for example, that visit from out of town, and this would be a perfect location. We've been to a few, but like the gems are where you can stay in the heart of downtown and there's more than one room or more than one bedroom, you know. a lot of things in Chicago, as it is in other major cities, you know, the rooms are can err on the small side. So it'd be nice if the couch pulled out to a bed, but it doesn't. So there's that. But then, so it's separate. So there's a pocket door, and then you're into the dressing area. And so that area is, you know, the double sinks. It's got a window in there. It's got the separate, like a private toilet room, just with a toilet in it and a full door with a lock. But the shower. So I think you would need to be awfully cozy with the person that you're sharing these spaces with. Not only this room, but the last room, which was a double-double. Because the only thing that's separating the dressing room is a pocket door. There's no lock. Just slides open. Then the shower in this room, it does have a frosted glass door,
which is nice.
And the last double double, it was just a shower curtain. So pocket door, shower curtain. And then this third room is basically a full-size bedroom. So I'm in here now, and there's a chaise lounge, of which Coco is enjoying. I think Coco's had a long day. She's watched Mommy do these videos. She's like, when is this going to be over? So, yeah, it's a full-size bedroom with a king-size bed. So, five windows. It's probably gets a lot of light. I think probably a bit of a nicer view. It's a nicer... It's a nicer room. It's a bigger room. So the other thing that I want to mention is, I know I talked about food options. And so everything closes in this hotel. The brunch spot closes at 3. The rooftop place closes at 9:30. And so since I was switching rooms around 9:30 or whatever to upgrade, I had to go across the street to this place. Luckily, there's a place across the street. It's called the Emerald Grill. And so, you know, I kind of looked at the menu online and walked over. It's an Irish pub. Didn't know what to expect. It was nice. It was a happening little spot. And I think for a weeknight, now maybe people are still celebrating New Year's, but I know, you know, people probably didn't have to work today, but they're back tomorrow. It was a lot of people, and it's sort of like a fish and chips, shepherd's pie. What I got was the boneless wings and a salad wedge and the French onion soup, which I don't recommend, but that's a whole separate review. But I just want to mention it because they're open till 2 a.m. And so that's great because the food was good. It's right across the street. And it's another, you know, if you don't feel like sitting in your room, they do have, look like they had TVs. And they have a drink menu. And the food was good. My bowl of swings were good. So that's that. So that wraps it up for this video. I basically had a wonderful time. This place is within walking distance to Grant Park, Millennium Park, Mag Mile, Michigan Avenue. Basically 250 rooms. Also Navy Pier is close by. And so if I had to rate this in terms of hearts, right? I would say for me personally, this has been, I mean, I'll go 4.5 because it's been nothing short of great, except for, I think, you know, if honestly, I think what would have made it like best for me would have been like a little mini microwave in the, because I've just been hanging out. And when you go to these restaurants and then you want to run around town and then you come back, you might have, a lot of people don't do leftovers. I do. So I give it 4.5 hearts. I should say the 4.5 hearts are based on a variety of factors, and so it's a scale of 1 to 5. And so for me, it's the comfy vibe. 2, it's the accessibility. Yesterday I got an Uber and went to a spa, and so other than that, it's within walking distance. It's in the Loop, which is also known as the business district, and so it's close to everything. The other thing is, you've heard me mention food multiple times. And so the food was good. Now the menus are short. So, you know, you gotta like a burger, you gotta like fries, you gotta like a taco, or a salad, but you know, they have more than that. But I mean, the food for what they have, it is very, very good. And, you know, it's just overall, I think I was very comfortable here and had a wonderful staycation. So again, if you've stayed anywhere, Virgin Hotels, you know, this is not sponsored, by the way. I should have said that from the beginning. I paid for this stay with my own money. I would say, check the website. They do have, I found them to be affordable. So a few months ago, I looked and the rates were, you know, different. But around New Year's, I booked with a third party, but I should have checked the website because for Illinois residents, they have a discount for Illinois residents. And then beyond that, the price on the website and the options were just as competitive as what I booked with the third party. In fact, the website might have been a little bit better, so I should have checked there first. Anyway, I had a great time. Thanks for stopping by.